Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this public multilingual reading. This performance involves children's books authors, illustrators, and publishers from around the world. They gather at Bologna Children's Book Fair, and they will read the 30 articles of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights in their native languages. We will listen to 21 or 22 languages, and you will see the article in English with the illustrations of a French artist called Jacques and his character Alex, who is the first digital ambassador for the United Nations. And I welcome, and please welcome onto the stage, the director of Bologna Children's Book Fair, Elena Pasoli, for a greeting, and thank you for being here.
Good afternoon, everybody, and thank you for both attending and participating in this important ceremony. I am proud of our association with the United Nations, and I'm particularly proud and moved to introduce this reading of the Declaration of Human Rights. First conceived in 1948, the 30 articles are dedicated have never seemed to so relevant and the world so in need of being reminded of their importance. We are dedicating this event to all those, and especially children, who are affected by war. I invite you to listen to our amazing lineup of guest speakers, and let's hope that their voices and the words they're reading may be heard far and wide. Thank you.
Thank you, Elena. Stay with us for a second, and I'm very pleased to welcome onto the stage Irina Lumensky, United Nations Publications, for a greeting on this important project and initiative.
Good afternoon. I'm Irina Lumensky from United Nations. I'm here on behalf of United Nations Publications and Department of Global Communications. I'm very grateful to Elena for inviting us. ...of authors, illustrators, and publishing, celebrating children's books. So we will spend the next few minutes reading all the 30 articles of the Declaration in the own language of our readers, which is also a celebration of multilingualism. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights was adopted by United Nations on 10 December 1948 in Paris in direct response to barbarism of the Second World War. The text is composed of 30 articles that set out universal values that transcend cultures, nations, and regions, in inalienable rights that we are inherently entitled as human beings. The group of 18 women and men from around the world, chaired by Eleanor Roosevelt, discussed and negotiated, refined and crafted the concept of the words over a period of 2 years, and the result has stood the test of time. Remarkably well, because here we are 75 years later with the Universal Declaration intact. It's also something to point to defend, and it's a testament to the wisdom of those who drafted it. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights has a Guinness World Record for most translated document in the world, over 500 languages and counting. That shows the importance for people around the world to have access to this fundamental text, no matter what language they speak. Very recently, we even translated into a few new languages, East Greenlandic, Mirandese in Portugal, and Valencian in Spain. Human rights are under threat today in many parts of the world. It's good to remind ourselves of their critical importance and relevance. In world conflicts, children, the younger world citizens, suffer the most. It's crucial to safeguard these human rights for them. Books are such an important vehicle for the idea of human rights from early age and encourage children to learn about them, champion them, and defend them. The author-illustrators who create their stories are waking up a whole world of imagination and ideas in the minds of children. The authors are also often the first to bear the brunt from those who seek to curtail the human rights. In writing, illustrating, and publishing, you demonstrate the power of literature in books to make change and remind me why I got into publishing in the first place. I hope that this event inspires everybody to stand up for human rights in our daily lives, publicly and privately, and what better moment than now to do so to celebrate the 70th occasion of the Declaration. So now, without further ado, I introduce Marcella Tarucci, who will be calling the readers. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Irina Lumensky. And you can both go take a seat and enjoy the rest of the celebration. And I want to say, I forgot to present myself. I'm Marcella Tarucci. I'm consultant for Bologna Children's Book Fair in Ages, and I teach at the University of Bologna. I'm really honored of being here and thankful to the organizers and also to the authors and illustrators. We have our jury members of this year. We have fabulous awarded illustrators. We have friends from all over the world who will lend their voice to say that humanity and childhood are invaluable. So I start and we go and listen the sound of so many important words in many different languages. Victor Santos, Brazilian Portuguese. Victor, please.
Todos os seres humanos nascem livres e iguais em dignidade e em direitos. Dotados de razão e de consciência, devem agir uns para com os outros em espírito de fraternidade.
Lola Shonein, Nigerian Pidgin English.
Everyone, 9 days entitled to all the rights and freedom, wait there for this small book. No matter the kind language where person they speak, the country where one come from, the kind religion where one they do, the kind thing where one they think. The kind person where one be, the how them take born one, the kind place where one come from, the kind property where one get, or whether you be man or woman. Them come talk again, say, them no go look at the way where them they rule that country, or how them they control the country, or the kind position of the country where they belong, whether in a free country, say no be another people from another country they rule there, or whether na them they rule themselves, or whether them get one ogbonge country where they rule them.
Thank you.
Sorry about that.
I wanted to argue. Paloma Valdivia, Spanish.
Todo individuo tiene derecho a la vida, a la libertad y a la seguridad de su persona.
Wevin Tushate, Norwegian.
Ingen må holdes i slaveri eller trelldom. Slaveri og slavehandel i alle former forbudt.
Nat Cardoso, Spanish.
Nadie será sometido a torturas, ni a penas o tratos crueles, inhumanos o degradantes.
Tahrir Ishazi, Arabic.
لكل إنسان أينما وجد الحق في أن يعترف بشخصيته القانونية.
Anna Marash, Slovenian.
Vsi so enaki pred zakonom in vsi imajo brez kakršnega koli razlikovanja pravico do enakega pravnega varstva. Vsi imajo pravico do enakega varstva pred sleherno diskriminacijo, ki bi kršila to deklaracijo, kakor tudi pred vsakršnim spodbujanjem k takšni diskriminaciji.
Kyoko Matsuoka, Japanese.
全ての人は憲法または法律によって与えられた基本的権利を侵害する行為に対し、権限を有する国内裁判所による効果的な救済を受ける権利を有する。
エリナ・ブレズリナ、ラトビアン。
Nevienu nedrīkst patvaļīgi arestēt, aizturēt vai pakļaut izraidīšanai.
Thank you. Andrea Antinori, Italian.
Ogni individuo ha diritto in posizione di piena uguaglianza ad una equa e pubblica udienza davanti ad un tribunale indipendente e imparziale al fine della determinazione dei suoi diritti e dei suoi doveri, nonché della fondatezza di ogni accusa penale che gli venga rivolta.
Inês Viegas Oliveira, Portuguese.
Toda pessoa acusada de ato delituoso presume-se inocente até que a sua culpabilidade fique legalmente provada no decurso de processo público em que todas as garantias necessárias de defesa lhe sejam asseguradas. 2. Ninguém será condenado por ações ou omissões que, no momento da sua prática, não constituam ato delituoso à face do direito interno ou internacional. Do mesmo modo, não será infligida pena mais grave do que a que era aplicável no momento em que o ato delituoso foi cometido.
Abiak Johnston, Inuktitut. Manon Gauthier, French. No, I'm going. Just a second. Che numero è? Il 13. Lee O Baek, Korean. Sorry for that.
Modern 사람은 자국 내에서 이동 및 거주의 자유에 대한 권리를 가진다. 모든 사람은 자국을 포함하여 어떠한 나라를 떠날 권리와 또한 자국으로 돌아올 권리를 가진다.
Quique Mendoza, Spanish.
En caso de persecución, toda persona tiene derecho a buscar asilo y a disfrutar de él en cualquier país. Este derecho no podrá ser invocado contra una acción judicial realmente originada por delitos comunes o por actos opuestos a los propósitos y principios de las Naciones Unidas.
Jérémy Moreau, French.
Tout individu a droit à une nationalité. Nul ne peut être arbitrairement privé de sa nationalité, ni du droit de changer de nationalité.
Oksana Karpiuk, Ukrainian.
Чоловіки і жінки, які досягли повноліття, мають право без будь-яких обмежень за ознакою раси, національності або релігії одружуватися і засновувати сім'ю. Вони користуються однаковими правами щодо одруження під час шлюбу та під час його розірвання. Шлюб може укладатися тільки при вільній і повній згоді сторін, що одружуються. Сім'я є природним і основним осередком суспільства і має право на захист з боку суспільства та держави.
Сільвія Бардел, English.
Everyone has the right to own property. Alone, as well as in association with others. No one shall be arbitrarily deprived of his or her property.
Airola Sari, Finnish. Let's make one step or let's stay in a group. Come, we don't like lines, we like a group. Just step. Just do like a group, okay? Thank you. come, so we get in the picture all together. Go ahead, thank you.
Jokaisella ihmisellä on ajatuksen, oman tunnon ja uskonnon vapaus. Tämä oikeus sisältää vapauden, uskonnon tai vakaumuksen vaihtamiseen sekä uskonnon tai vakaumuksen julistamiseen yksin tai yhdessä toisten kanssa, sekä julkisesti että yksityisesti, opettamalla sekä harjoittamalla hartautta ja uskonnollisia menoja.
Victoria Tentler-Karlov, Russian.
Каждый человек имеет право на свободу убеждений и на свободное выражение их. Это право включает свободу беспрепятственно придерживаться своих убеждений и свободу искать, получать и распространять информацию и идеи любыми средствами и независимо от государственных границ.
Сара Мацетти, Итальян.
Uno, ogni individuo ha diritto alla libertà di riunione e di associazione pacifica. Due, nessuno può essere costretto a far parte di un'associazione.
Mark Janssen, Dutch.
En ieder heeft het recht om deel te nemen aan het bestuur van zijn land. Rechtstreeks of door middel van vrijgekozen vertegenwoordigers. In ieder heeft het recht om op voet van gelijkheid te worden toegelaten tot de overheidsdiensten van zijn land. De wil van het volk zal de grondslag zijn van het gezag van de regering. Deze wil zal tot uiting komen in periodieke en eerlijke verkiezingen, die gehouden zullen worden krachtens algemeen en gelijkwaardig kiesrecht. En bij geheime stemmingen of volgens een procedure die evenzeer de vrijheid van de stemmen verzekert.
Prashant Patak, Hindi. Which is 20. Manon Gauthier, French. Excuse me. Manon Gauthier.
Toute personne en tant que membre de la société a droit à la sécurité sociale. Elle est fondée à obtenir la satisfaction des droits économiques, sociaux et culturels indispensables à sa dignité et au libre développement de sa personnalité, grâce à l'effort national et à la coopération internationale compte tenu de l'organisation et des ressources de chaque pays.
Prashant Patak, Hindi.
Pratek vyakti ko kaam karne, ichha anusar rozgar ke chunav, kaam ki uchit aur suvidhajanak paristhitiyon ko prapt karne aur bekari se sanrakshan pane ka hak hai. Pratek vyakti ko saman karya ke liye bina kisi bhedbhav के समान मजदूरी पाने का अधिकार है प्रत्येक व्यक्ति को जो काम करता है अधिकार है कि वो इतना उचित और अनुकूल मजदूरी पाए जिससे वो अपने लिए और अपने परिवार के लिए ऐसी आजीविका का प्रबंध कर सके जो मानवीय गौरव के योग्य हो तथा आवश्यकता होने पर पूर्ति अन्य प्रकार से सामाजिक संरक्षणों द्वारा हो सके प्रत्येक व्यक्ति को अपने हितों की रक्षा के लिए श्रमजीवी संघ और बनाने और उसमें भाग लेने का अधिकार है
बेल सांतोस मायर पुर्तगीज
Toda pessoa tem direito ao repouso e ao lazer, especialmente a uma limitação razoável da duração do trabalho. E a férias periódicas e remuneradas.
Ebony Waitere, Maori.
Ko ia tangata e whaitika ana, kia whiwhi ki te oranga e hāngai ana, ki te oranga tōtika mo tōna tinana me ona āhuatanga katoa. Ona ake me tāna whānau, i te kai, i te kākahu, i te whare, i te rongoa, me ngā whakaora i ngā māwiwi o te tinana. A tai atu ki ngā huarahi toko i te ora mo te iwi e tikana. A me whiwhi hoki ai i te tika, me te manaakitanga tūturu mōna i ngā tūpuno mai, ngā wā koremahi, ngā māwiwi o te tinana, ngā wharanga, te pawarutanga, te kaumātuatanga, ā te kore rānei e whiwhi e te oranga mōna i runga mai i ētahi āhuatanga, kore nei e taia e ia te pēwhia ake. Ko ngā wahine whānau me te hunga tamariki e tika ana, kia āta whakaarohia, kia manaaki hoki. Ko te katoonga tamariki aha koi whānau mai i te hunga mārena, ka hore rānei mārena tia, Me te mainga kia rite tahi te whiwhi, ngā āwhina, o ngā ritenga toko i te ora mo te iwi.
Ali Bozari, Persian.
ماده 26, بند اول. آموزش و پرورش حق همگان است. آموزش و پرورش میبایست دست کم در دوره‌های ابتدایی و پایه رایگان در اختیار همگان قرار گیرد. آموزش ابتدایی میبایست اجباری باشد. آموزش فنی و حرفه‌ای نیز میبایست قابل دسترس برای عموم مردم بوده و دستیابی به آموزش عالی به شکلی برای تمامی افراد و بر اساس شایستگی فردی صورت پذیرد. بند دوم آموزش و پرورش میبایست در جهت رشد همه جانبه شخصیت انسان و تقویت رعایت حقوق بشر و آزادی‌های اساسی باشد. آموزش و پرورش باید به گسترش حسن تفاهم، دگرپذیری یا تسامح و دوستی میان تمامی ملت‌ها و گروه‌های نژادی یا دینی و نیز به برنامه‌های ملل متحد در راه حفظ صلح یاری رساند. بند سوم، پدر و مادر در انتخاب نوع آموزش و پرورش برای فرزندان خود مقدمند.
میتیا آزمان، بنگالی.
প্রত্যেকেরই সমষ্টিগত সাংস্কৃতিক জীবনে অংশগ্রহণ করা, শিল্পকলা উপভোগ করা এবং বৈজ্ঞানিক অগ্রগতি ও তার সুফল সমূহে অংশীদার হওয়ার অধিকার রয়েছে। বিজ্ঞান, সাহিত্য ও শিল্পকলা ভিত্তিক কোনো কর্মের রচয়িতা হিসাবে নৈতিক ও বৈশ্বিক স্বার্থ সংরক্ষণের অধিকার প্রত্যেকেরই থাকবে।
Marius Marcinkevičius, Lithuanian.
Kiekvienas žmogus turi teisę į tai, kad visuomenėje ir tarp tautų įsiviešpatautų tokia tvarka, kurioje galėtų būti visiškai įgyvendintos teisės ir laisvės išdėstytos šioje deklaracijoje.
Neil Baker, English.
Everyone has duties to the community in which alone the free and full development of their personality is possible. In the exercise of their rights and freedoms, everyone shall be subject only to such limitations as are determined by law, solely for the purpose of securing due recognition and respect for the rights and freedoms of others and of the meeting the just requirements of morality, public order and the general welfare in a democratic society. These rights and freedoms may in no case be exercised contrary to the purposes and principles of the United Nations.
Please stay. Tomas Rizek, Czech.
Nic v této deklaraci nemůže být vykládáno, jako by dávalo kterémukoliv státu, kterékoliv skupině nebo osobě jakékoliv právo vyvíjet činnost nebo dopouštět se činů, které by směřovaly k potlačení některého z práv nebo některé ze svobod v této deklaraci uvedených.
Thank you to all our authors and illustrators who landed their voices, just we stay together as a group and for a nice photo, and have to say that we hope that these words will resonate in languages, countries, hearts and become peace and rights from being word to be real substance very soon. Thank you.